Hi, I'm Thomas from Neuzeit Instruments, and I'm excited to announce some groundbreaking new features for our WARP synthesizer module. We now have a new wavetable generator on board that is powered by artificial intelligence. Yes, you heard right. This little thing now uses a neural network to help you create wavetables and overtone spectra on the fly. As far as I can tell, this is the first AI application in Eurorack format, and I think it may even be the first one ever in a hardware synthesizer. But there is more to this firmware update, like a really nice sounding stereo widening algorithm. Also, it is now possible to save knob positions in a preset and recall them when loading the preset. This can be a real game changer, especially in a live set. At the end of the video, I will give an overview of the other improvements and new features that have been added since the first version, such as MIDI CC support, 32-bit WAV import, an improved high-quality sound engine, and much more. So the firmware update is done in no time from a computer using the micro USB cable that comes with each unit. Please check out the links below, and if you like the Neuzeit channel, I'm always happy to welcome a new subscriber. So now, let's get started. I will not cover the whole synth engine in this video, but for now you just need to know that this area up here is the so-called galaxy, a large pool of overtone spectra that form the basis of the sound palette. These overtone spectra are translated in real time into wavetables that the oscillators use. WARP has several editors on board that let you intuitively draw your own overtone spectra in the galaxy or extract them from wavetable files on the SD card. But with the new AI editor, you get a really fast way to design a whole set of wavetables in no time. So when we enter this editor, we see 9 green markers in the galaxy up here, which I call anchor positions. The AI will suggest new waveform variations for each of these 9 positions. At the end, when we are done editing, we can press para and bake all the green areas into the galaxy at once. Locations in between these green dots will be interpolated, so our job is to find nice sounds for the 9 anchor positions, which will then determine the overall sound of the galaxy. By turning the para encoder, I can cycle through the anchor positions and we hear the sound stored at the location. There are no effects or filters applied, so in a galaxy editor, we hear only the raw waveform that results from the overtone spectrum. We can also see the overtone spectrum here in the middle, and this is already one that the AI has imagined for us. When I turn down the mix, it blends into the original galaxy waveform, and we see that the AI version is only slightly different. But the fun part is that the AI imagines a whole bunch of evolutions from this initial starting point. By turning any of the other 3 encoders, we can now explore the variations it has imagined. When we reach the full 360 degrees, we are back at our initial starting sound. I am now using another encoder to explore a different sounding set of wavetable evolutions. And let's do the same for the third encoder. We can also engage all 3 paths at once to get a new mix of these different spectra. We can also toggle between spectrum and waveform view by pushing the bottom right encoder. By turning the para encoder, I switch to the next anchor position and look for a different sounding timbre here. I repeat this for the other positions as well. So as I turn the para knob, we get an idea of what the galaxy will sound like at the anchor positions. By pushing the top right encoder, I can unlock the XY potentiometers, and now I can use them to navigate across the galaxy. So we can also hear what is between the anchor points. When unlocked, you see this white dot here that indicates what we are seeing in the display. And pressing the lock encoder again will lock the blue dot, our listening point, to the white dot, our editing point. This is, by the way, exactly the same for all Galaxy editors. This switch here enables a really fun feature. It enables auto-rotation, so the waveform keeps changing its timbre. Also, volt per octave, CV, tuning and MIDI note receive are still enabled in this editor, so we can use WARP as a pure oscillator with a sequencer, for example. Okay, now I think this is a nice sounding Galaxy, so I want to keep the whole thing. So I hit the para encoder to bake everything. Keep in mind that this is just the starting point of the whole synth engine that follows. So let's listen to our newly created Galaxy in action. Okay, I will try to give a musician-friendly explanation now of how this kind of works under the hood. So what we usually call artificial intelligence is actually a neural network, which is another term for a giant digital filter with tens of thousands of parameters. So as an engineer, you don't set these parameters by hand. You let the neural network find them by what is called training. So the key to success is to build a good and very, very large training set. In our case, it consists of thousands of overtone spectra that people actually use or would use in music production. Then you start training the neural network, which means it learns how to reproduce the training set bit by bit. But the really cool thing is that if you do it right, it can also come up with things that it has never seen before, but that sound like they could have been part of the training set. So when you build the training set, you rely on what is already there or what you can make up in the head. But when you get to the point where the machine is coming up with stuff that is somewhat new, then it seems fair to start using the term intelligence. So when training is done, we can actually use the AI. So in our editor, for each anchor position, we feed an overtone spectrum that we already have through the neural network, and it will predict its own version of it. And as said, the neural network is basically a giant multi-stage filter, and we feed our spectrum through that filter and take the response of the filter as the new spectrum. So the initial output will be something similar to the input, but with the three rings, we can now slightly modify the intermediate results of the neural network and force it to come up with something a little different. So that's how we create these kind of evolutions. But because the filter is so complex, it is not possible to give the rings a clear label like cutoff frequency or highs, mids and lows or anything like that. So the only thing we know for sure is that the output of the filter is likely to sound something like that could have been part of the training set. So neural networks are always somewhat unpredictable black boxes, but we can take advantage of this kind of controlled randomness. So a real random generator would also come up with stuff that would not make sense at all and would probably sound awful, while the trained neural network has something we could call a musical taste. Okay, I hope this gave a little insight into how this works. So if you are interested in AI, I can only encourage you to dive a little deeper. And it is certainly not the solution for everything as sometimes suggested, but it is a super interesting field of research. There is also an option to export WARP's Galaxy as a WAV file for use in a third-party wavetable synth. So WARP can be used as a creative tool to quickly create wavetables for your other synthesizers. This is not a new feature, but let me show real quick how it works. We go to the export menu and set the wavetable specs that our target synth expects. These are the number of samples per wavetable, the number of wavetables, sample rate and bit depth of the exported file. Up here we select a path over the galaxy along which the wavetables will be collected. By pressing para, WARP saves the WAV file to the SD card. I copied this file to my computer to use it in Ableton's wavetable synth. To import the file, I just drag and drop it on the wavetable window, and now we can use it. For Serum, it is quite similar. We can choose from different import options, and I choose constant frame size. Okay, so let's move on to the next feature. I'm really excited about an all-new stereo widening algorithm that is now built into WARP, which you can find in the oscillator and mix section. It is very easy to use, but very powerful. So just listen how the stereo field expands. The spread parameter is also saved in presets, so you can have different amounts of stereo width. Our algorithm won't touch anything below 100 Hz and leaves the bass nicely in the center for great mono compatibility. Another new feature is the ability to recall knob positions with presets. This can come in very handy if you're using WARP in a live set or in a setup that relies heavily on using presets. Until now, only the galaxy and parameters that were set via the menu were part of the preset. But with firmware 2.0 or later, the current potentiometer positions are also stored in the preset. There is now an option to recall the potentiometer values when loading a preset. You can find the setting in Settings, Global, Catch Values of Presets. So let me give an example. I save the current state as a new preset as I want to recall it later. Now I play around with the knobs a little more. And now I load the preset again, and although I changed the potentiometers, I am back at exactly the previous sound. However, the physical positions of the knobs have changed and don't match the position anymore that WARP is currently using internally. But the display gives us some orientation to turn the potentiometers across the internal position and thereby catch the values. The big lines show the actual pot position and the little markers show the target positions. So when I move this pot over the target, we practically catch the stored value, and you can hear that the potentiometer is in effect again. So we have to move all the knobs and capture the values, and once we have captured them all, the overlay disappears. And we are back to what you see is what you get. If you want to skip this process, you can simply press the back button. This will make the overlay disappear, but you will still have to cache the values. However, now you can see the contents of the display again. Alternatively, pressing the para encoder will close the overlay and jump to the physical knob values instantly. If a CV is patched, you can also see how the CV changes the value. So the target value can also be captured with a CV. To sum it up, you can use the value catch option to recall the sound exactly as it was. The downside is that you have to move the knobs to their safe positions after loading to get the pots working again. Actually, this is the way most non-modular synthesizers handle presets, but most of them leave you to guess the value of the knobs without any help in the display. If you are the kind of modular user who expects every knob to show the actual value as it is, then you may want to choose the classic way of loading presets. This is also still the default after the firmware upgrade. Last but not least, there are some other new features that are new to firmware 2.0 or have been introduced in recent updates that you may not have on your device yet. In March 2024, the audio engine was upgraded so that it now uses a much better anti-aliasing technique, and especially for high notes, the sound is much clearer now. The amplitude and phase modulation effects also have been updated to sound more pleasant. WARP can also import 32-bit, 8-bit and micro-law encoded WAV files now into the Galaxy. The most common 16 and 24-bit formats were already supported. We also released the firmware this winter to expand WARP's MIDI capabilities. You now have full MIDI CC control and can also recall presets via program change. There is a MIDI mapping table in the manual that helps you reach all internal parameters. In addition, you can also use MIDI CCs like virtual patch cables to alter the potentiometer positions. Please note that MIDI requires the WARPX expander. With each firmware release, there have also been some minor improvements and little bug fixes here and there. Okay, that's it for now. If you're not sure how to update your WARP, check the links below, and if you have any questions, please feel free to drop us an email, join us on Modwiggler, or leave a comment below. Thanks for watching!